Good morning, class. The chapter that we are going to study today is migration. Now, if you all remember, when we were doing the chapter population dynamics, we learned about certain factors which affected population. They being the birth rate, the death rate, and migration. Now, when we talk about migration, children, migration was immigration and immigration. That we have already taken up in the previous chapter. So today we are going to learn about, in detail we are going to learn about migration. So whenever I tell you to underline, please take your pencils and you start underlining. Now we all know what is migration. Early humans moved from Africa to other parts of the world, according to the anthropologists. Although they did not have full-fledged evidence about the reasons of movements, they all concluded with the fact that the early humans migrated across the world. That is, people moving in as a whole from one place to the other. Migration, in simpler words. Population gain in many places due to movement since the early times is found in the recorded history. Now, migration and its types. Migration is an important component of population feature. Migration can be defined as the movement of human race either in groups or as individual from one place to another for a variety of reasons. Maybe not in detail, but we have already touched upon this topic, so I'll not take too much of time on this and we'll read ahead. So please underline, can be defined as the movement of human race either in groups or as individual from place to place, place to another for variety of reasons. Now, the reason for human migrations are different today than in the early times. Earlier, one of the main reasons was extreme climate. For instance, the reason for the movement of people from Africa to other parts could be the arid climate, very dry and hot. If we look at the present waves of migration, it is either economic or political. This also, the political factor also, I have already taken up, discussed in detail with you when we were doing population dynamics. People move from one village to another, from village to town, and from small town to big city, and finally from big city to another country. It is not always so, but then in general, this is how things move. Underline, it changes not only the size of the population, but also the composition of population in urban and rural areas in terms of age and sex composition. Broadly, we define migration under two major types, which are discussed below. Now, before we go to international migration, please let us read, do you know? According to an estimate in 2000, 2.9% of 175 million people were living outside their country of origin for more than 1 year. This is all migration. Now, international migration. We are talking about here different kinds of migration. In the previous chapter, we only talked about immigration and emigration. So let us see what international migration is all about. It is the process in which a person moves permanently from a country of origin to a country of destination. For instance, a person moving from India to Canada. The general trend of international migrations is from the less developed nations to the more developed nations. It is very obvious, children, that all this is in search of better employment opportunities, better living standard. A large number of people may move from one country to other in search of better living standard, education, and health facilities. Now, immigration. The process in which a person enters a country to live permanently is called immigration. You go to another country. It increases the total population of the destination. Of course, this it is bound to happen. For example, a person entering the United Arab Emirates. Therefore, immigrants are those who arrive in a country from some other country. Now let us see what emigration is all about. The process, let me just adjust the camera over here. The process in which people move out from their native countries to reside in another country permanently is called emigration. It decreases the population of the place or nation of origin. For example, a person moving from India to the USA. Therefore, emigrants are people who leave a country and go to another country. Now over here, they have just given you, given a map over here of Syria and its neighboring countries. Now, let us come down to the next paragraph in emigration. Let's see what it is all about. In some instances, people are forced to migrate as well. When people leave their native countries due to war, natural calamities like famine or some unavoidable social and political situations, they are referred to as refugees. This is the case of the Syrian refugees. So this is why they have given you the map over here of Syria and its neighboring countries. The case of Syrian refugee is one of the greatest crises in the present day world. Now, just a few months back, India and other countries were dealing with Rohingyas, refugees who were coming from Bangladesh. Let us come back to the chapter. The Syrian refugees started abandoning their own country in the early 2011 with the outbreak of civil war. A civil war is when people of the same nation, they end up fighting with each other. Maybe there is a difference of opinion in their traditions, in the language they speak, or they belong to different clans or tribes. Since then, they are forced to migrate out of their own land and seek refuge in other nations. Not all people like violence. Some of them shun violence. So these people, they do not stand for a cause. They just want a peaceful life. So this is the reason why these people, they have left their own country and emigrated or taken refuge in the neighboring countries. Till now, 11 million Syrians have moved in to the nearby neighboring nations as well as other countries. Now let us talk about internal migration as well. It is the process in which people move within their own country, either from one state to another or within the state, that is from one town to the state capital or to another bigger city. Now as we live in Mount Abu, so we know that Mount is full of small and big hotels, and the people, the labor force over here is not just from Mount. They come from different places as far as Mumbai. Some of the girls studying in the school are also from different cities, different states. So labor force is also, when we talk about Mount Abu, a lot of labor is here from different places in Rajasthan as well as Gujarat. So that is a good example of internal migration. People moving from Uttar Pradesh to Delhi is an interstate migration, whereas people moving from Lucknow to Kanpur within Uttar Pradesh is an example of intrastate migration. So it's something very simple to remember. Just underline all this. So it can be said that for better job prospects and fulfillment of aspiration, people have dreams, desires, okay? They have goals. So just to fulfill these goals, these dreams, people migrate to different cities or different areas. People migrate from a rural or semi-rural or even smaller towns to some bigger cities within the state or other states within the country. It has been observed that people migrate permanently from one place to other within a country in two ways, which are discussed here. Now, children, this migration, internal migration in a country, this rural to urban and urban to urban, this we will discuss in the next video, which I'll upload in the next class. As of now, you know that we have already uploaded the question answers of this particular chapter. Please make sure that you read each and every answer 5 times so that things become clear to you. Anything which we have studied up till now is not clear, please note it down in your book, and when the school reopens, we'll discuss it again in detail. Thank you.